Hello, mic test. Hello guys, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're interested to know how to calculate Piotroski F-Score using Alpha Vantage API in Python, then you're at the right place. In the last few days, I've got many comments on one of my most watched videos, Piotroski F-Score in Python, that the API that I referred, which is Financial Modeling Prep, is not working. Unfortunately, yes, they have stopped providing free data outside USA and they started charging a lot of money for their data. Maybe the reason is me. I have surely provided a lot of clients to them. I've got around 3.5k views on this video, but no worries. We have more free finance APIs and one of my favorites is Alpha Vantage. I've already covered this in this video. You can click on this I button to know how to use Alpha Vantage in API. And in this video, we will calculate Piotroski F-score using Alpha Vantage. Before we start building the model in Python, if you are new around here, on this channel, I turn you into a successful financial programmer. Here I upload videos on things like trading bots, free finance APIs like this one, Alpha Vantage, implementation of AI in finance, etc, etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then smash on subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, I offer an amazing gift to all my lovely subscribers. I'll tell you in this video. So let's start. Although I've already explained what is Piotroski F-score in this video, let's have a brief idea about the score. As per Investopedia, you can see that Piotroski F-score is used to find the most valuable stocks, or I would say cheap stocks in the market. And it is basically a score-based system where we provide different scores, either 1 or 0, based on the type of financial of that company. So you can see that there are different types of considerations for Piotroski F-score, such as profitability, leverage, liquidity, and fund source of funds, operating efficiency, etc. And we give different points based on different parameters, such as if the company is having positive net income, then we give 1 point to it. If it has positive return on assets in the current year, we give 1 point. Similarly, positive operating cash flow in the current year, 1 point, and so on. So for different things, we give 1 point. And if the company does not comply with this rule, then we give 0 points. And in the end, what we do is we just add all these points. If the company is having a higher Piotroski score, it means that it is a more valuable stock, or I would say cheap stock in the market. I mentioned this website in the description box. You can refer it to know more. Let me first show you which code did we write for this Piotroski F-score video. And this is the code actually. You can see that I have used Financial Modeling Prep API in order to extract the financial data. And then I used some basic functions that I'll be using in this video as well. And in the end, I just calculated the Piotroski F-score like this. This code is actually present in my Google Drive. And this is actually the gift to all my new viewers as well. You'll get to know what you need to do in order to get a free access of my Google Drive. And also, this is the code that we made in Alpha Vantage video, this one. And you can see how we can use Alpha Vantage API to extract the financial information of any company. So now what we'll be doing is we'll be using this code as a reference and this code as a reference to make a code for Piotroski F-score using Alpha Vantage. You can click on this I button to watch this video, which is Piotroski F-score using Financial Modeling Prep API. We'll first start with installing Alpha Vantage API, which is pip install Alpha Vantage. If you want me to make more videos on different types of models using Alpha Vantage API in Python, then just click on the like button. If it crosses 200 likes, then I'll make more videos on different types of implementation of Alpha Vantage API. And there can be a lot of implementation because it's an amazing API. Just click on like button and then I'll cover a lot of videos on this. If you have any suggestions, then mention in the comment box and I'll feature a few of you in my upcoming videos. So we'll have to import Alpha Vantage library first. So from Alpha Vantage dot fundamental data, import fundamental data. The key is equal to this one. How did I get this key? Click on this I button to know more. I already mentioned in my last videos. Now we'll have to start with this. FD is equal to fd is equal to fundamental data, and then I'll provide key output format is equal to pandas. Now let's suppose the ticker is equal to Apple. Now in order to get the income statement of the company, we can refer to this code which we made here. By the way, I'll disable this key. You need to have your own key, of course. You can get it for free, so I'll be disabling this key after recording this video anyway. So I'm interested in income statements, so this one, and then this is the get balance sheet, that get income statement, so fd.income statement, and then symbol. So let me just write is1 is equal to fd.income statement, and in this case we have ticker, not the symbol. If I run this and let's see what is is1 now. Okay, so we'll have to get its zeroth item. So this is the income statement, perfect, but it should be in the transposed format. If I do it like this, perfect, we have got the income statement. You can see that we have done the same thing here as well. We got the income statement, then we used this thing, and then we transposed the data. Now why it's 2 and then colon? Because you can see that these two rows are not useful, although this one is the one that should be in the columns. Actually, I have changed it here as well. I've changed the columns to this row, which we'll be doing here as well. So let me just write it like this. So I'm only interested in this. So for example, let me just write it like this. Is is equal to this, and in the end is dot columns is equal to, and then let's just copy and paste it like this. So list of fd dot get statements, we don't need to run this line again because we have already got it here. So is1 and then 0.t and then I lock and then this one, perfect. So if I run this cell and if I do it like this, I should have the income statement of Apple in front of me with the columns to be the actual dates, the financial, the fiscal dates of Apple. Now similarly for balance sheet of the company, I'll do the same thing. I'll just copy and paste it like this. I'll just need to change is to bs, list of this is to bs, and then I'll go here is to bs, and rather than having fd dot get income statement, I would be required to have get balance sheet annual here. So that's it. And if I run this and it like this, you can see that we have got the balance sheet of Apple with the dates and the fiscal dates as the column headers. And lastly, for the cash flow statement of the company, I'll just copy and paste these lines and then just change BS to CF, this one as well to CF, list of this to CF, and then rather than having the get balance sheet annual, we will be required to copy this and then paste it like this. So let's see what is the cash flow statement of Apple. You can see that you have the cash flow statement of Apple in front of you for different fiscal years. Now, I don't want to write all these functions and make this video long. What I'll be doing is I'll be referring all these functions and then make it for our code. So let me just pause this video for a moment and come back. So yeah, I just wrote all these functions for the Alpha Vantage. So this code will be saved in my Google Drive. Let me tell you how to get a free access of my Google Drive for my new viewers. What you can do is just click on the subscribe button and click on access to my Google Drive button, and then just follow some steps over there. And on this Google form, you just provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address to provide a free access of my Google Drive. Let me tell you one thing. This code is present in my Google Drive. There are many more codes which are present over there. Everything is free for use, no copyright issue for you. It's just a gift from my side. So yeah, I started with net income. You can see that here also net income, return on asset, operating cash flow, long-term debt, all these things. I explained each and everything in my last video as well, the Piotroski F-Score video as well, but I'll just give you a brief idea what I've done here. So the net income, I've made a very basic function for this, and you can see that from the income statement, I have taken out the net income. Why 0? Because I'm referring to the last net income, which is the most recent net income of the company. Return on assets, you already know that return on assets is equal to net income divided by average assets, which is average total assets, which is actually the average of this year and the last year's total assets. For that, I just referred to balance sheet, and then you can see that this year's total assets is referred with 0 and the last year's is referred with 1, and then just I took a basic average and then net income by average assets. Operating cash flow can directly be taken from the cash flow. Long-term debt can directly be taken from the balance sheet, and you can see that if there's an increase or decrease in long-term debt, you just need to subtract it from each other. The current ratio, you already know, it's current assets by current liabilities, and in this case what we need to do is we need to see whether the current ratio is increased or decreased. If it has increased, then we'll give 1 point here. How I have done here is I've just taken the total current assets from balance sheet of this year and last year, total current assets from balance sheet of this year and last year, and then you can see that I've just calculated the current ratio of this year and last year and then subtracted with each other. The new shares issues, we can see the change in the common stock from balance sheet. The cross margin is easy to calculate as well, and you can see that the asset turnover ratio, for this we had to refer to both income statement and balance sheet. We have to extract the total assets, the total revenue, and then calculate it and then subtract it with each other. Lastly, what I've done here is here also you can see that I have calculated the Piotroski F-score. So if the net income is greater than 0, Piotroski score will be added by 1, and all these things. So similarly, I have done it here as well, and there are many experts who consider this Piotroski F-score to be a very important score for calculating the for getting the cheap stocks, or I would say the value stocks in the market. Talking about the industry experts, I have a big announcement to tell you. After crossing the 3000 subscribers milestone, I will start having conversation with industry experts and start putting videos on this YouTube channel. We will discuss about the upcoming trends, jobs availability, and the future prospects of financial programming, financial engineering, and quantitative finance domains. If you're interested, let's cross this milestone as soon as possible. And I'm really very interested to have a different dimension of financial programming with Ritvik. So if you run this cell, and then if you just call this function, which is Piotroski score, then you'll see that the value of Piotroski score for Apple is 7. You can change the ticker here and then run all the cells again to calculate the Piotroski score of that particular company and find some cheap stocks for you. If you like this informative video, then you can support me on Patreon. The link is in the description box. On Patreon, you can see that there are 6 levels and I offer different benefits for different levels. Your contribution means a lot to me as it keeps me motivated to work harder. You can see that there are many plans in my mind, and for all of them, I need your support. And I'm telling you, I won't disappoint you. You've just seen the trailer. The movie is yet to come. The link of Patreon is in the description box. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there you can see that how I calculated Piotroski F-score in my last video, and over there you can see how we can use different finance free APIs to extract a lot of financial data. Don't forget to like this video. See you in my next video. Thank you.